Okay. 7:49 right now. Hey, National Baby Safety Month is just about to wrap up. It was this entire month, but there are so many important reminders for parents year-round. Melanie Bangle, a certified car seat installation technician, and she's also a paramedic with Community Ambulance. She is here to go over some of the basics. And parents, we know you get kind of busy during your daily lives, and these are some of the things we might forget. So, Melanie, yes. Thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely.
I want you to get right down to it, because I know the car seat is one of the biggest problems that you see.
Yes, 95% of them are installed wrong.
Yeah.
And the child is actually harnessed wrong into the car seat.
Okay.
So what a lot of parents don't do, unfortunately, is they don't read the manual that comes with it.
Mm-hmm.
You definitely have to read the manual that comes with it. You need to make sure that it is the appropriate size.
Okay.
For your child, because children are different sizes and weights.
Of course.
So the manual will tell you how big your child can get. And they also tell you when you should turn the child around from forward to rear facing.
Uh-huh.
Studies show that children should stay rear facing hopefully until they're at least four.
Oh, really?
Just protect their head, neck, and spine. Yes, yes.
Rear facing until they're four?
Yes.
I can tell you most people I know with kids have never done that, self included.
Yeah. Just because they can hold their heads up, their muscles still aren't very strong.
Okay.
So if you get into an accident, the rear facing is meant to cushion and cocoon their head, their neck, and their spine.
Okay.
And those are the most important parts, you know, that get easily injured on a child,
sure.
on a young child.
Yeah. Do you guys offer classes, Melanie, for parents to come and check
we do
out?
Have events that parents can come. They can bring their children, bring the car seat. We can tell them how to properly install them. We have information on our website, communityambulance.com.
Okay.
They can also send us an email. And info@communityambulance.com, and we can tell them when our next event is coming.
Okay, great.
So we do actually have events every month, a couple a month, that parents can bring all over the valley. They can bring their children in their car seats. So we can show them how to properly install them, how to harness their children properly. Car seats expire. Parents need to look at the expiration dates on them.
Oh, man.
So there's a lot of stuff that comes,
comes with
car
with
seat
it, yeah.
safety, with child passenger safety.
Okay, let's move on to some of these products here.
So these are a lot of our common household poisons, including medications.
Mm.
A lot of our, you know, child poisonings are from grandparents or parents' medications.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like candy.
Yeah.
So these boxes that we have, the monthly box that a grandparent will put on their counter, kids can climb up and grab it.
Okay.
So you need to keep your medications in the prescription bottle with the child. The child locks on the top, the caps.
Mm-hmm.
Also, household appliances or cleaners that are kept under the sink. Well, Gatorade looks like Windex and Lysol looks like apple juice.
Oh,
so
no.
For young children, even though they're three, you know, four, they still can mistake cleaners for drinks, and
you know
they will
what,
open
Melanie,
them and they will drink them.
You just scared me to death there. It does look like Gatorade and that one looks like apple juice.
So yes, you need to put them on a shelf high up where a child can't reach it or get the locks.
Yeah, and then we're seeing the Tide Pods there.
Tide Pods.
A lot of the detergents,
the
they
bright
look
colors,
like that.
Yeah. They call, you know, the children are attracted to them. Same thing with medications. You need to put them in a cabinet where the children can't get them. You can get locking medicine cabinets for your bathroom.
Okay.
So don't put them, you know, even in your garage, you need to always keep your eye on your kids.
All right.
So, and another thing is safe sleeping positions. So in order to avoid, you know, like a SIDS death or a smothering, babies need to be on their back with nothing
in the crib,
but
right?
a blanket.
Okay, yeah.
And also make sure you don't overheat your baby. People will put so many layers on their babies. They're going to sleep in what you're going to sleep in.
Okay.
One layer is fine. Pillows, extra blankets, lots of stuffed animals. Children will flip over and they can smother in those. You never want to co-sleep with your child ever, even
ever.
On the couch. I know a physician here in this town that fell asleep with his baby on him on the couch, and the baby fell into the
The crevice
the cushion
of the couch,
and the baby smothered and died.
Okay, Melanie, we are out of time here, but folks, just a quick reminder, the ABCs of safe sleep, the babies need to sleep alone, on their backs and in their crib. So just, again, some safety reminders as we get back into the swing of things in the school year and heading up to the holidays.
Yes.
Melanie, thank you so much. I know
Absolutely.
Josie was listening very carefully to all the tips here. She's a new mom. So, all right, Jason, over to you. See what you got to do when you become a parent. You got to listen and be aware of all this stuff.
That is shocking.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.